Life is rough.
You gotta take the time to focus on what brings you joy.
As the Japanese say, ikigai.
Or, what am I nerding out about right now?
Join us at the gaming table.
Or reading nook.
To find your happiness.
I'm Laney.
I'm Marshall. And this is Elated Geek. Hello, everyone. This is Marshall. I'm all by myself for this one. This is the second part of our time travel episode that I did as part of the Spinner Rack Kids secondhand. If you haven't heard that one yet, go ahead and go on back. In that one, Corey and I talked about a whole bunch of time travel comics, what we felt about them, how they ran, and he kind of teased that this is something that is kind of a sticking point for me. Time travel is probably one of my favorite concepts in fiction. I don't know if I've ever really talked about it too much, but I really like time travel and the logic of it and all of that fun stuff. And unfortunately, a lot of mainstream television and movies and comic books and novels in general fail hard. They fail hard. I'm just going to be honest. I feel like they don't think everything through. In case you hadn't picked this up by now, this is going to be a rant, and it's going to be a rant on a very heady and sometimes confusing subject. As such, I'm going to try and use pop culture references as much as possible so that you can kind of figure out what I'm talking about, because just talking about it straight can sometimes make your head turn backwards, and no. So, we're going to talk about time travel. And I'm hoping that this is also going to be really helpful for those people who are planning on being writers, or people who have just watched that one episode of their favorite show, and the episode is a time travel episode, and it just left you feeling like something didn't happen right. And hopefully that will help you figure that out. A lot of times, writers think that they can, like, just go, time travel, cool, I'll throw in a paradox, and I've got a good story. Those people are wrong. So let me give you a couple of examples. We have two very opposite ends of the spectrum here. One was the television show Timeless. I think it ran for two, maybe three seasons. It was an interesting show. It was basically, the whole concept was that these terrorists had gotten a hold of a time machine, went back in time and started changing things. So the people who made the time machine called up FBI, CIA, somebody, and now they're using the prototype to go back and fix everything. And so obviously, you know, there's this big tension point. These guys have changed time on us. And while it was interesting, I spent the entire time just irked by the huge plot hole that the entire story was based around, and we will get to that. On the other end of the spectrum, we have the MCU, especially right after Endgame and then going into the television show Loki, and we're going to be going into a whole new phase of storytelling for the MCU because of what they did with their time travel and how they took all the rules and the paradoxes and just said, no, we're not doing that. And that's something to remember. While time travel does open up some interesting avenues for storytelling, getting bogged down and focused on those paradoxes can make things happen wrong. So when you're planning on telling a time travel story, there are two aspects that you always need to iron out. One is the method of time travel. And while you do need to have that ironed out, it doesn't really matter for the purposes of this conversation here. It's all technobabble. Time travel is, like, theoretically possible, but we haven't been able to find a way to theoretically do it. Theoretically. The other, and far more important point here, is cosmology. How your universe, your multiverse, your omniverse is structured will tell us whether your time story makes sense from day one. This is all about logic, all about how your alterations to the past affects the present and the time traveler. And we've got our cosmology in two different flavors. One is a single timeline, and the other one is a multiple timeline cosmology. When a character goes back and changes the past, do they fundamentally alter their present and future, or do they return to everything being the same? The MCU uses a multiple timeline cosmology, and it kind of explains it effectively. A simpler explanation exists in Dragon Ball Z, of all places, with the stories of future Trunks. After everyone he loves is killed by evil androids, he goes back in time to save the main character of the show, Goku, from a heart attack. This should, in theory, defeat the evil androids and save everyone. Except, when Trunks returns to his future, nothing has changed. He realizes that his changes created a whole new timeline, one where Goku didn't die, and the original timeline, the one that he came from, still exists. In a multiple timeline cosmology, every change creates a new timeline, and you could, potentially, jump between these two parallel timelines and have them interact in really interesting ways. A single timeline cosmology does the opposite. Every change overwrites reality. There's only one timeline, and any others that exist, exist in theory only. You can't bounce into the other timeline. It isn't there. The best example of this is actually in Back to the Future 2. Biff gives the almanac to his past self, so when Marty and Doc return to their present, it has now become a dystopian horror, ruled by Biff. When they go back and they fix this, by the end of Part 3, everything is back to quote-unquote normal. Each change overwrote the entire timeline, and the only way to skip timelines is to alter your past all over again. The biggest differences between these two cosmologies lay in the big conflict of time travel, paradoxes. This is where the logic of what you changed makes two things true that can't be true at the same time. Multiple timelines render paradoxes completely moot. You can't change your own timeline, you just create a new one, so no paradoxes get created by what you do. On the other hand, single timeline cosmology is just one big paradox. Just the act of creating a time machine alters the past in some minute way. How do you know how it changed things? You don't. But there are several paradoxes that we could put our finger on and really discuss so that when you're writing your own stories, you kind of know what to go for. The most popular is the Polchinski's paradox, or the grandfather paradox. You go back in time, accidentally do something that prevents your own birth. That then means that you were never able to go back in time. And if you can't go back in time, then who unbirthed you? See, this also happens if you accomplish your goal for time travel, thereby giving yourself no reason to time travel. Like, let's say you went back and killed Hitler before he did all that stuff. But now, he never did all that stuff. So there's no reason for you to go back in time and kill him. And if nobody went back to kill him, then he does all the bad stuff. This example comes from the book How to Kill Hitler, A Guide for Time Travelers by Andrew Stanek. And this has gone by a bunch of different names, and a lot of different people have discussed it in a lot of different permutations. So we're just going to call it the grandfather paradox and go from there. Ultimately, this paradox is also the reason why shows like Timeline simply don't work. See, the bad guys go back into the past. Hurry, all you good guys, go back and stop them. Otherwise, they'll overwrite all of reality. Except, how would you know? If the bad guys change the past, then the new past is the only one you've ever known. The overwriting of the timeline occurs at the point of the change, not at the point where the bad guys left the present. So, there's no hurry, because you can literally go back to fix things at any point, but that's if you know what changed. Which you won't, because it already changed and you don't remember what the old timeline had. This paradox has also had a lot of different writers come up with solutions for some of these paradoxes, specifically the grandfather paradox itself, killing your parents or grandparents before you were born. One of the main ones that people use is timeline course correcting, or it actively working against you causing changes. Like, you try and shoot your grandfather, the gun just jams. Or you shoot your grandfather, but later on somebody else becomes your grandfather, and you were born anyway, causing you to go back in time. And that's a whole other story. Quantum Leap actually went a step further. It made the main character jump through time, fixing things that evil time travelers had changed. Even better, they didn't even reveal the evil leapers until multiple seasons in. It was a great slow burn. So rather than the universe just automatically trying to fight time travel changes, instead, the universe created agents to fix itself. It's kind of awesome. My personal favorite, however, is the concept of traveler's immunity. The idea that the time traveler themselves is immune to changes in their own history. And that kind of opens up the story a little bit. As you go back in time, now any changes that you make, you still remember your own past. And when you come back to the present, everything is different. On the opposite end of the spectrum, you have the bootstrap or predestination paradox. Lots of people have a hard time with this one. Pretty much every time I've tried to explain it to them, they're like, that doesn't make sense. So I'll take it slow, and I'm going to use an example from Doctor Who. Let's say you go back in time to meet Mozart when he was first writing his music. You find, however, that Mozart doesn't exist. He was never born. And neither were his parents. Yet, you know his music. You've got a phone full of his music. So you pick up a pen, you start writing down all of Mozart's songs, and put his name at the top. When you return to your present, Mozart's music still exists. But how? Where did it come from? Was there another long-lost timeline where Mozart did exist, and you are merely aping him? Or were you predestined to go back and become Mozart? Can your traveling through time actually be an action that causes time to run the way it's supposed to be? Or is time travel always the anomaly? A great example of this is actually Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Seriously, if you haven't watched it yet, you don't love yourself enough. In a way, Paper Girls by Brian K. Vaughan is the same way. There isn't a solution for a bootstrap paradox. It simply exists. If you use it properly in your writing, you can do some really deep storytelling. In fact, let's leave off with a story idea I had, one that centers on the bootstrap paradox. The main characters hear about a phone number. If you're ever in trouble and the police won't come, text that number. Vigilantes with incredible technology will come and save you within seconds, no matter where you are. The main characters are rescued in this way and decide that they're going to look into these vigilantes. They come to find out that their rescuers are, in fact, time travelers. People from the future will look at the records of the texts that were left at that phone number and use that to determine where they have to travel back in time to rescue the people that they already rescued in the past. Over the course of the story, the main characters and the rescuers interact enough that the main characters invent a rudimentary form of time travel based on what they learn from the future, creating the very technology that was once used to rescue them. What do you think? That's all for today's rant on time travel. Hopefully, if you're a writer, this has helped you. If you aren't a writer, maybe this has inspired you. At the very least, maybe you figured out why that one time travel episode bugged you. Leave us a comment, or if you want to hear me rant about time a little bit more, or rant about anything else a little bit more. Seriously, I love time travel. I could go on forever. So, thank you for listening to Elated Geek. Follow us on social media for pictures and more info on things we talked about in today's podcast. You can find Laney on @ZaneyLaney or me @OneTrueHazard. You can also find @ElatedGeek on our Instagram. And you can also find ElatedGeekTweets on Twitter. If you want to go to a website, we have www.elatedgeek.com. Links for these are in the show notes.
If you want to help us to continue to bring you new and exciting things to nerd out about, please consider donating to our Ko-fi account. The link is in the show notes, and every donation is accepted with total appreciation for your support in us.
Send us your geek obsessions or topics that you want us to experience and talk about in future episodes. Email us at share@elatedgeek.com.
And until next time,
geek out.